Everyone, welcome to round two. We have unfortunately lost the roll again, and this time we, I think, have to mulligan again, just like our last game in round one. We do have a Force of Will and Shackles, and those are pretty good, but Force of Will isn't really actually the nuts since it's card disadvantage, so I don't want to have to use it on some spell that would cause us to die. We do have a Spellskite, which could give us enough time to sort of draw into more lands, but I would rather just skip a reroll. So let's go ahead and mulligan. Alright, let's go ahead and try that one more time. Let's mulligan. Okay, this is better. So we'll go ahead and keep this, and hopefully we're not playing against a deck that's too aggro. Ooh, there's a Spellskite. That's good. Hopefully we're not dealing against Reanimator also. Could be a Reanimator deck. I'd rather play against aggro at this point since we have Spellskite. So we're going to go ahead and I think just play this Spellskite because our Juicy Apprentice is really the only thing that we've got going on here, so let's go ahead and get that in play. Basalt Monolith. Okay, well, I think probably gonna want to leave remand up since we just, especially since we just drew Dismiss. Liliana of the Veil. So let's go ahead and remand that. Actually, we can let that happen and then play Jushi and attack it next turn. Then that'll give us Dismiss. That's interesting. Yeah, I think I'm just going to remand it. Give us more options. Ooh, Vidalkin Shackles. That's a nice card. And then next turn, we can just hold up. Dismiss. And then next turn, play Jushi and Shackles. Dismisses Liliana. We really want to. Him to Torok. Okay, you can have Liliana, I think. I don't really want to discard those cards. Ooh, that's pretty sickening. Is he playing Grave Titan? Grave Titan. Okie dokie. Well, what can we do about that? You know, this guy is the one that I was really hoping he didn't have. So we know he has Liliana in his hand. So I think what we're going to do is play Shackles. And take a guy. And hopefully, let's see. Grave Titan. What exactly gets rid of that? Not too much. Liliana is fine, unfortunately. Each player discards a card, you say? Well, I think we are going to get rid of either Flametongue Kavu or, let's see, Sword maybe? I mean, all these cards are pretty bad. We want to keep the Oracle. So let's see. I guess FTK is going to put enough power into play so we could potentially kill the Grave Titan. So we don't want to get rid of that. And this Sword is probably going to be, I think it's probably Jushi Apprentice. So we'll go ahead and get rid of Jushi Apprentice. Because next turn we're going to want to play Seagate. Yeah. Alright. So we'll get rid of Jushi Apprentice. Or it's Sword. I mean, he's going to have very few cards in hand. Although Sword plus Flame Tongue is a combo. Yeah. Yeah, we'll just get rid of Jushi Apprentice. That's fine. Bloodghast. Jeez. That's not very cool. Okay, so I think what we can do now is we can shackles a zombie, an untapped zombie, and either block, use Spellskite to block one of his attacking zombies, and then hold on to the zombie, play FDK, kill his other zombie, attack Liliana. And that would be okay, so let's go ahead and try that. We take 8. Or we could take a zombie, block 2 zombies. I'm just going to take an untapped zombie, block both of the zombies. And let Grip hit him through. So we're taking 6 down to 14. And Phyrexian Rager. Okay. So let's untap our shackles, draw a land. Well, that's not bad. Okay, so I guess we're going to go ahead and play FDK, kill his Rager. And ship the turn. Looks like Sword of War and Peace is probably going to be out of here, since he's going to make us discard, I think. We'll have to wait and see. Pristine Talisman. Yep, that's fine. Probably just going to go ahead and tick up Liliana, so one of these cards is going to go. And in the case that he does that, I think it's going to be Sword, since Seagate Oracle. If he doesn't do anything with Grave Titan, then we can always just shackles a zombie and attack him with it. Then if he doesn't, if he blocks, then we can play Sword of War and Peace and equip our Flame Tongue Kabu. Sort of interesting, I guess. There's a few more islands, and then we're home sweet home with Grave Daddy. Daddy's home, and he's very angry. Target player sacrifices a creature. Okay, Spellskite is down. So, now I can go ahead and attack with both zombies, but not the Grave Titan. So I'm going to go ahead and shackles his one of his guys first. So, if he wants to attack, he can only do it with a zombie. Or a Grave Titan. I mean, I'm going to double block his Grave Titan, and if he attacks with just a zombie, then I'm blocking with the zombie. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and not untap. Desolate Lighthouse. That was not the land I was looking for. So I'm going to go ahead and attack Liliana now, I think. And then if he does something, let's see, he can play Seagate Oracle. Yeah, because he's probably just going to block with his Grave Titan. Maybe. I can play Seagate Oracle into Sword. Let's see. The red spells I have left in the deck are not too many, so we'll go ahead and tap like that. So this will let me sacrifice the Seagate Oracle if I want to. Cryptic Command. So that's a card. Desertion is also a card. I think I'm going to take Cryptic Command. Leave Desertion. And now we can either, let's see, we can play around Cryptic Command. Let's see. I think I don't want to use Cryptic Command just yet, because I'm going to Because that'll let him get a hit with Grave Titan in. I could also just... I'll be able to counter a spell next turn. I mean, I could have, like, tap, bounce his zombie. Okay, untapping his basalt monolith. Each player discards a card. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and get rid of Sword of War and Peace. So by us discarding Sword of War and Peace, something should be up for him. So we're gonna go ahead and let him go to attack. And so now what do we want to do? I think we're gonna go ahead and tap his team, draw a card. I'm just gonna wait. Let's see. Alright, so there's another land. So I think what we can do is go ahead and play this mountain, and then if he goes to do anything, we can... Let's see, if he has a land, if he draws a spell, he's gonna go land, play a spell, then use Liliana. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna play this, and then tap his team and bounce his Grave Titan. Night's Whisper. Oh, well, that kind of sucks. I was hoping that he would draw a spell. Each player discards a card. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is tap his team and bounce Liliana. Tap his team, bounce his zombie. Tap his team, bounce his zombie. I guess this wasn't the best use of Crypt Command. I was really hoping that his line of play would involve playing a land, then the last spell in his hand, but I guess Night's Whisper sort of foiled that. Alright, so we are discarding a swamp, lo and behold. Mirror Battle Sphere. Okay. Well, that's kind of good. Yeah, let's go ahead and untap that. Since we can take his Battle Sphere. Oh my. Is that a good draw? I think that was a good draw. Okay. So let's go ahead and control magic his Grave Titan. Was that a good draw? Jeez, I'm so lucky. Probably misplayed this pretty badly. Alright. So now we're gonna have to wait for him to do something. We have the sack of creature. So I think what we're going to do is we can take the Battlesphere and then sack the Seagate Oracle. Alternatively, we can take the zombie. We can take a mirror. I think if we take the mirror, that's going to be best. Because then we can take the Battlesphere and just sack that. Yeah, I think we'll do that. I think that's actually going to be the safest. Because now if we'll get that off the board so we can actually, so we don't have to worry about it. Hopefully he doesn't have a reanimation spell. Now he can just let nug us with this, but we can put FDK on Amir and then Seagate Oracle on something else. Now he's got 6 power, but we've got shackles, so he can't block with everything and kill our Grave Titan. So we'll go ahead and untap that and draw an island, which still may be good. So let's go ahead and smash with everything, except for, and when I mean everything, I mean just Grave Titan. And we'll go ahead and attack him. We'll attack Liliana. Sure. Well, this is kind of cute. Grave Titan. Man, this thing's a house. It's one of the better cards. So we'll go ahead and see what he's going to do. He's probably just going to chump with one. Oh, he's blocking with everything. He's like, all right, well, it's kind of interesting, I guess. I wonder if us using shackles on his guys is going to prompt a concession. Maybe not. Well, let's see what he's got. Yep, sure. Sign damage like that. Then we'll go ahead and use the lighthouse in a turn. Vampiric Tutor. Okay. One. So we can draw into a negate. He's probably going for something like Damnation. I guess playing the island would have been better. Because he can just take up Liliana. Yeah. Oh well. Yeah, that was probably pretty bad. Yeah, especially since we have shackles. I mean, that would be the only reason to play the island, really. So he's going for probably something sickening. Sickeningly good. We'll have to wait and see. Didn't even bother untapping his basalt monolith, but alright, we'll see. And, right, no. Gain life, lose life, hold on. Each player discards a card, sure. Dothy Horror. And we have Damnation. 5, 6, 7. I hope this isn't Shieldred. All is dust. Okay. Well, we still have shackles, so that's good. Alright, so go ahead and untap that. He has a Bloodgast. Sure, we can play Kira, why not? Let's go ahead and S6. And so it's our Kira against his nothing, so good. And, yeah, that was a good draw also. Off the top. We'll go ahead and suspend that thing for 4, I think. Should be pretty good. Suspend. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I deserve to win this game. And what do we have? 4, 5, that's a lot of mana. 7? I hope this isn't Shieldred. Gristlebrand. Alright. It's pretty good. Lake of the Dead. Alright. And we're at 14. It's a good number to be at. Hopefully we can draw something. 5, 6, 7? Yeah. Alright. I'd probably use Gristlebrand right now if I were he. But I guess he doesn't want to do that. Oh, he wants to do it now, you say? Okay, well, that is also fine. Well, there's one island, so let's go ahead and loot. Yeah, we'll go on that. And I guess we can't attack, so just pass the turn. If we had that island in play, man, we'd be one off. He would have Dothy Horror, I guess. That just is unfortunate. So we're going to be in a little bit of an uphill battle, to say the least. Probably going to be chumping with Kira. Maybe. Not yet. I don't know how many edict kind of cards he has. Gristlebrand. Jeez, that was something. Well, it does a card. Probably has Shieldred also. Shieldred would be pretty good. Mimic Vat. Alright, I guess we're not chomping. Not yet. Yep, you have a Mimic Vat. And a top, sure. It's going to be sort of tricky if we go to the interaction between Kira and Vidalkin Shackles. He'd have to put one into play first. Yes, it's going to be something. Liliana of the Dark Realms. Target creature gets plus X or... Okay. That's interesting. Search your library for a swamp. Okay. Do you want to draw some more cards with that? I would appreciate it if you did. Alright, he's going to attack us. I am not blocking anytime soon. I am going to kill no one. Alright, so let's go ahead and take your Bloodghast. Get over here. Auto yield to that, draw an extra card, an island. Look. Wow. That is something. What does that do for us? Nothing much because he has Mimic Vat. So. It's kind of interesting. I think what we're going to go ahead and do is play this. Attack Liliana. Play the Suven Shapeshifter face down. And then when he goes to attack, we can unmorph and turn our shapeshifter into a Gristlebrand. Because he won't gain life, it'll go under Mimic Vat. I mean, he'll have the chance to get both, but we'll just have to wait and see what he does. Eight cards. I wonder if we can outlast that. Look. Even if he has sudden death. I don't know if sudden death's on the cube. We can still unmorph as an instant. So how many lands do we have left in our deck? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And surprise! Bam. What's going on? So he's going to stack triggers, and if he removes the shapeshifter, that's probably a little bit worse for us, just because we have a legend. And that would be a legendary play for him. Especially while we have the Vidalkin Shackles out. So we're just going to see what he does. Can't really do anything about it. He's taking out Gristlebrand, okay. And just Gristlebrand, so that works out for us. So now what are we going to do? We're going to have to give him back his Bloodghast, I think. This is going out of one, so still need this island, so we're not going to loot. So I don't really want to bank on... I mean, actually have to have an island in play, so I can't loot and just risk. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and untap. And I don't think we want Ancestral Visions, so let's go ahead and see what we're going to draw into. Siege Commander. Well, that's a card. And he doesn't have black mana, so we'll go ahead and discard Ancestral Visions. Target player. Actually, no, let's hold on to that. So let's discard that. And let's see, if we attack, right, beginning to combat, gaining life, looking at the top. Yeah, so this Ancestral Visions is probably going to target him, and we do have careful considerations left in our deck, so we could deck him. So I think I actually want to attack here. He will probably not do anything. So I don't want to block. Then I would, yeah, that would be bad. I'm actually not going to attack. I'm going to pass the turn. This is a little tricky. So he's going to mimic that. That's fine. And then we're going to go to attack, and he's going to swing at both, but I think I'm just going to take this now. So he can't swing with anything. And therefore, I'm not forced to block. We can end the game right now. Just pay 7 life like that. So could he. He's got 7 cards. Bring it. I ain't got afraid of you. Yeah. So the mimic vet is exile. And Chronicler has 1 card counter on it, so it's coming into play. Living Death. All right, sure. So what are we gonna do? I think we are going to That's kind of interesting. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and FTK his Dothi Horror. And see what we draw. Snapcaster Mage. That gets a something. Remand, Cryptic Command. Yeah, we'll take that. And so now he can exile that. So this is all very interesting. So we're just going to auto yield to that thing for now. So we don't have a flyer, so we can't actually use the Dolphin Shackles on anything. And he can force us. Not good. You know, his Crypt Command bounces. Bounces Mimic Vat. That's always an option. Kind of like that. Let's see, 2, 4, use Shackles. So, yeah. And we can draw a card, Hex Parasite. Okay. Bitter Blossom, sure. Exile Gristlebrand, sure. Alright, so let's untap that. Draw a card. Casting this Folio. Drawing a card, Willbender. Okay. Snapcaster. Cryptic, 2 lands, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we can't use Play Siege Gang yet. So let's see. We might actually just be able to kill him. He's going to 19. These are offsetting. 6 cards. End up take. I think if we. What is Willbender going to do? Willbender is not going to do much of all anything. So. Yeah, that Mimic Vat's going to be pretty problematic. So I think we're going to go ahead and try and careful consideration him, maybe. It's going to be 5-4. It's looting, so we're going to... Alright, let's see. So I think we have the Snapcaster to kill his, to tap bounce his team. And then we can use Siege Gang for whatever he ends up... for whatever he ends up playing afterwards. I mean, Shackles, also whatever he ends up playing. So that's 4, 5, 6. Shackle, or Crypt Command. Siege Gang. We could play Siege Gang and just not. Yeah, let's do that. Siege Gang and then... Snapcaster Cryptic. Alright. Jeez, this is something. So we're going to play Snapcaster Cryptic, tapping his team, bouncing Mimic Vet. And he can make a guy in response, but... then it'll get tapped with Cryptic Command. So, flashback. Tap all creatures. Return target permanent to your own its owner's hand. 1, 2, 3, 4. So he can make a guy if he really wants to. One, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And he's replaying Mimic Vet. Volcanic Island. Okay, so let's see. We've got 1, 5, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15. So we should have him dead on the board. Assuming he doesn't have any removal, that is. Alright, so I'll go ahead and nug him out. Alright, so we're going to have a little bit be pressed for time since I ended up using a lot of time for that game, down 5 minutes. We're going to go ahead and put in this negate. Let's see, flames is pretty bad. Rain Freeze, let's see, what else? Brimstone, Holy Searing Blaze, Worn Power Stone, Apocrysite. I mean, the red is pretty bad, so I think we're just gonna, we can go into black if we really want to. That's fine. This is not very good, so we'll just play Apocrysite, Worn Power Stone, or we can go Creeping Tar Pit, Undermine, Psychotog. Seems good. Necromancer, Putrid Gruel, so we'll go Opt. Apocrysite seems kind of meh. He has Living Death, and so play. We can still play. Let's see, what else? Spellskite, Plating Mirror, Shackles, Sword. I guess Sword is okay. Let's go with Opt 41. I'll play a Mishra's Factory, cut an island. And that should be good. So, yep. Or Brain Freeze would be good, any good. Probably not. Let's go ahead. It's land 16. Okay, so we need to cut one card. We can cut an Apocrysite, I think. Or we can cut Worn Power Stone. I think I'm going to go ahead and cut the Worn Power Stone. And add an island. There we go. 17 lands, 11 creatures, Mishra's Factory. We'll try that.